Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to customize the combobox items, header, and footer using templates. Let's move on to the coding part. I will open my existing application, which already has the Syncfusion React dropdowns package installed. On the app.tsx page, I have included the basic combobox component rendering code. If you need to know how to create a basic React combobox component, you can refer to my getting started video linked in the card above or in the description below. With this code, you can visualize an employee list. Let's take a quick look at the data I have bound to the data source property of the combobox component. Let me run this application and show you the output. Look at the combobox. When I click the drop-down icon, the employee list will be displayed. First, I'll show you how to customize the combobox pop-up list items using the item template property. I declare a method, customItems, and design the template items with images. I include the image tag with the class name employeeImage and provide the source from Syncfusion demo sample. Here the images are accessed using employee ID from props variable. Then display the employee name and job with the proper class names. I open the app.css page and define the styles for image, name, and job. Assign this method to the item template property. Look at the combobox pop-up list now. Image, name, and designation have been added to each list item. I can also customize the pop-up header using the header template property. I create another method, custom header. Then in the template design, I show the header texts, photo, and employee information. I assign the class name, header to this element and column header to this. In the app.css page, I define the styles for the classes, header, and column header. Assign this custom header method to the header template property. See here, the combobox header has been customized based on the template. I can also customize the footer using the footer template property. Here I add another method, custom footer, and add custom text, add new items. Also, I will show the plus icon by adding the class name e-icons+. In the app.css page, I specify the content for the plus icon. Then assign this custom footer method to the footer template property. Check now, the combobox pop-up list has a footer based on the provided template. Finally, I will show you how to customize the noRecords content using the noRecords template property. Here, I have already added an empty JSON object in the data.js file. Import that data object and use it in the data source property. By default, combobox shows no records found content while binding empty data source. I include the no records template property and provide the custom content no records available. See now, the provided template is displayed when no records are found. Let me recap what we have seen so far. I showed you how to customize the combobox list items, header, and footer using templates. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. I've also provided a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.